Welcome everyone to my channel that is Fast and Easy Maths, which is dedicated to give you tips and tricks related to mathematics. So students, today we are going to solve a few questions which was asked in SAT practice test, and these were those exams where there was no calculator. Okay, so a lot of my students faltered in few of these questions, so I thought let me make a video of that and I'll tell you where these students made a mistake so that you all don't make these kind of mistake while appearing for your SATs. Okay, so the question is, if x raised to a square upon x raised to b square is equal to x raised to 16 and x is greater than 1 as well as a plus b is given as equal to 2, then find the value of a minus b. Now first things first students, very important thing to know is that you have to understand few concepts before appearing all of these entrance exams, just as SATs, ACTs, GMAT, GRE, all of that. Okay, and the basic crux, or rather there are few things which are common to all of these exams, and that is indices. So you have to have a very clear understanding of your concepts of indices. In case you all don't know or you all have confusion in that, please mention so in the comment section. I'll make a separate video of indices itself. Okay, now coming back to the question, now we know that it is given as x raised to a square upon x raised to b square is equal to x raised to 16. Okay, here we will use a law of indices, which is when the bases are same, okay, and the indices are different, okay, then you can actually write the bases as nothing but subtraction of the indices. So how will you do that? The law of indices say that a raised to m upon a raised to n is equals to a raised to m minus n. Okay, so now in this case, can I say that x raised to a square minus b square is equals to x raised to 16? Okay, now please understand that since the bases are same, okay, we, like in this case, if this was equal to a raised to q, okay, if this was equal to a raised to q, then we could have directly said that m minus n is equal to q. Okay, so here in this case, I'm going to write over here, that is a square minus b square is equal to 16. Okay, now we know that a square minus b square can be written as a plus b, and a minus b is equal to 16. Okay, now over here we have the value of a plus b, which is equals to 2 into a minus b is equals to 16. Now since we just needed to find the value of what, just a minus b, so I can say a minus b is equals to 16 upon 2. That gets me the answer of 8. That's my answer. Okay, so you saw how easy this entire sum became only because you have a clear understanding of indices. Okay, and students, apart from these, there are few formulas which you need to have a very clear understanding of, that is a square minus b square, that is first formula which we just understood, that a plus b the whole square, a minus b the whole square, then a plus b the whole cube, a minus b the whole cube, and a cube minus b cube, a cube plus b cube. All of these formulas are really important for you all to actually crack these exams. Trust me, if you have these basics clear, you will not find these questions that tricky or that difficult. Okay, also students, if you like the way I'm explaining, then please go ahead and hit the like button, because that gives me tremendous amount of encouragement in doing these kind of videos. Achha, now let's come to the next question. If root of x plus root of 9 is equals to root of 64, what is the value of x? Okay, so now please understand, before explaining this, I will tell you where most of my students made a mistake. You know, this concept was not very clear. Some of them did a plus a square plus b square. Okay, that is where they made a mistake. Okay, and here, and some of them too actually did a square upon b square is equals to 16, which is also wrong. Okay, Here, most of them made a very silly mistake of taking a square minus b square is equal to a minus b the whole square. Please understand, a square minus b square can never be. Okay, so please remember, a square minus b square is never equal to a plus b the whole square. Please understand, or rather a minus b the whole square. Sorry. Okay, these are the few things which you need to always remember while attempting any of your entrance exams. Okay, so now coming back to our question, what is given to us is root of x plus root of 9 is equals to root of 64. Now students, we understand that root of 9 is nothing but what? Can I say 3? Why? Because square root of 9 is 3. Why is that so? Because 3 square is equals to 9, therefore I can say root of 9 is equals to 3, correct? So now similarly, what is square of which number gets you 64? Yes, 8 square gets you 64. So taking root on both the sides, we'll say 8 is equals to root of 64, right? So we'll write this as nothing but what? 8. Okay, and this we keep as it is. Okay, this is where most of my students made the mistake. They directly did squaring both the sides just to get rid of this square root. Please understand, if you do squaring both the sides, you will still be stuck with 2 root x into root 9, which is 3. Okay, please understand. So you do not have to simply complicate something which is already given. Okay, and which can be solved very easily. So now understand, root x is equals to 8 minus 3. Can I say that is equal to 5? Correct? But please understand students, this is the value of root x. And the value which they are asking for is x. So what should be the value of x? Yes, you all got it right. Squaring both the sides, I will get rid of this root. And since I'm squaring, it will be 5 square, which is equal to 25. So your option D is my answer. So you saw, this is so easy, but here also most of my students made a mistake because they took x as 5. Actually the value of root x is 5. So there are few things when you are attempting these kind of entrances or these kind of practice tests, these actually help you to understand that you are not paying attention to the small nitty-gritties of your question. Okay, so while reading, please have a very calm mind and check what is actually being asked for. Okay, so yeah, that's it for now. And apart from this, if you have any doubts in any of the topics, any of the entrances like SAT, ACT, GMAT, please put an email to me. I will definitely make a video on the same. So that's it. See ya in the next video. Bye.